In this video, I'm gonna share with you 5 tips on how to recognize and handle burnout. Burnout is absolutely a real thing, and coming from someone who has been there before more than once, I wanna share with you guys some things that have helped myself in the past and will hopefully help you as well. Hey, I'm Juliana Lane, and I'm a singer, songwriter, and full-time content creator. If this is your first time here, make sure to hit that subscribe button so you can catch more covers, original songs, and creative inspo to help you find your voice. Let's dive in. If you are starting to feel burned out, it is so important to recognize your emotions and to talk to someone about it, both for your sake and for the sake of those around you. It's kind of like when you bottle all of your emotions and don't take time to process your feelings. You are bound to explode on someone if those emotions are left unchecked. When we start to put words to our feelings, it is so incredibly validating, like I can't even tell you. I'm a singer-songwriter, so writing songs and lyrics is literally my entire way of processing everything that happens in life. A lot of times, I won't understand the true depths of my emotions until I intentionally take time to write them out. Then you have this like light bulb moment where your emotions like finally start making sense to you. Finally! And once you understand your exact emotions and why you're feeling them, you can actually address how to deal with those emotions. This leads me to my second point. Is there a repeated pattern to why you keep feeling burned out? For me personally, I am such a go, go, go person that it is so hard to slow down and stay slowed down. It is literally an everyday struggle that I am working really, really hard on, but you have to be like really intentional about it. So it is definitely a struggle. If you're finding that your main source of stress is coming from a lack of good habits, you need point number 3. You need boundaries. My problem is that I say yes to everything. It's literally the worst. Don't do it. Highly don't recommend. Boundaries are just a really fancy way of saying I have respect for myself, for my time, and for my health. I know that saying no literally feels impossible sometimes, but I guarantee you could do it too. It's liberating, really, because then you're not a slave to everyone else's calendar. It's okay to say no. You're saying yes to something else. I've had that phrase as my wallpaper on my laptop for months now, and it is seriously the most encouraging thing whenever I start my day. Type in the comments, I'm saying yes to something else. By saying no, what are you saying yes to? Your mental health, self-care, more time with your family? Whatever it is for you, let me know in the comments. If you are in a constant state of overwhelm, now is the perfect time to start prioritizing what is most important for your health. Go ahead and write down everything you do in a week, and I mean everything. Whatever does not have to stay on your calendar, just let it go. You won't do much good to anyone, including yourself, if you are involved in everything and spread too thin. Try cutting back to the bare bones and bring more joy and energy to doing a small handful of things well. Now, I know it's not always possible to just drop things from your schedule depending on your situation, but whenever possible, take a break or even take a sabbatical. It's interesting because I learned today that the word sabbatical derives from the word Sabbath, which, duh, it makes so much sense. We need Sabbath rest. Just as Sundays are an intentional day of rest, we can set aside dedicated time with the Lord to pray and to listen to what He has planned for us. When things are spinning out of control, we can lean on the Lord and He will give us rest. Just remember, if you have been feeling burned out, you have to try something different to get different results than what you've been getting. And be patient with yourself, because healing does not happen overnight. It really does take time. I promise you, when you take time to rest, you will come back stronger than ever and ready to go change your world. If you like this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up and let me know in the comments what video you want to see next time. Thanks for watching.